Hey guys, how would you like to talk to spirits and trust yourself if you are a non-believer? If you are unsure if spirit signs really exist? If you'd like that, stay tuned to my channel and subscribe below for more stuff like this. My name is Colleen Winia, and I'm a Reset Your Vibe energy coach helping you trust your vibe and trust your instinct. I help you navigate life transitions. So if you want to connect with your loved ones so that they can be your best cheerleader, so that they can help lead your path with you, especially when you feel, you know, alone after grief and loss. I've been through 20 plus years of grief and loss, and I have worked with clients for 18 years. And so many clients have been through, we've all been through a grief and a loss. And I've come to recognize, I used to question like, what happens when you die? And I didn't know that as a little girl until my first two beloveds, my dad and my cousin Rob, transitioned. And so I'm gonna share with you a couple of ways that you can just talk with them and to recognize them and allow them to walk the journey with you. So first of all, talk with them. How do you talk to spirits? Well, just like I'm talking to you now, talk to them, call out their name, ask them to show their presence to you. Talk to them like you are in a prayer, right? Meditation is receiving information, and prayer is like talking to God, talking to source, talking to spirit. Well, if it's your loved one that you're thinking about, it's the same thing. You call them in. And so just talk to them. You can talk to them out loud when you're walking and you're driving. You can talk about them to your beloveds that are alive right now. You can talk to them when you're driving in the car. Call out their name. And so that's the very first thing, is treat them normal, because this is a multidimensional world. That's another time for another video. And you can communicate with them, and you're not taking away their presence. If they're spending time with you, they can still be with their other family members as well. People ask me that question all the time. Well, can they be in this place over here and then on the other side of the world? You know, can they pop up for you, Colleen, and then be there for your niece? You know, like my sister transitioned, and is it possible for her to be around me and then around her as well? And the answer is yes. But today let's talk about how to talk with them and how to recognize them. So this is to find out or to discover or to deepen your connection and your trust. Now, why would you even want to do this in the first place, right? Why is it so important? Well, think about it, right? The first thing we do when we lose a loved one is we grieve. You know, I got a smile on my face right now, but when this first started happening, I did not have a smile on my face. Neither do my clients when they've are going through this. Okay. So by the way, connect down below. Okay. So I want you to know that I have a stream of spiritual education videos that actually show some really cool signs and things that have happened to me. So right off the bat here, if you like anything from this channel, please like, please comment, please put your questions down below. I do my best to get back to you guys. And subscribe and click on the link below for more spiritual educational videos, and check out my ebook as well. I'll cover that one again. There's a reason for that. It's about connecting with your spirit, with your vibe. So one of the first ways that my beloveds show their signs to me is through moving objects. So what can happen is when a beloved wants to talk to you, or you want to reach out to them because you're missing them, you may notice signs around you where objects have been displaced, right? So this is generally speaking to people who are organized. If you're like messy and you've got clutter all over the place, that's not your deal, right? That's not your personality. That's not your, you're not like one of those like, ooh, everything's in the right place where you're gonna notice it. So they may or may not, but probably not so much, choose to connect with you at that level. So for example, for 25 plus years on my side table in my bedroom, okay, so this is my story here for you, is I have different things placed on the side table in the bedroom. But it's really, really funky because over the years, things change. I've always had a side table, But right now, for example, that's more present time, I have this like beautiful vase. It's a clear glass vase. It's filled with gorgeous stones and some quartz crystals. Actually, the quartz crystals, there's some placed around it as well. And for whatever reason, the corner of the side table, the nicely placed vase, and it's like angle, I'll go in and it's like been moved closer to me. So if you walk towards the table, it actually has come out from the wall, the edge, it's come closer, and it's basically, we'll just say it's been moved, okay? And then over time, if I don't touch it, kind of let things get dusty a little bit, I notice it can move closer and it can move closer. And this is like, all our loved ones have certain, you know, you hear about spirit guides, like, you know, whether you believe, like, there are beloveds all around us. There's spirit guides, there's ones that have transitioned, there's greater source of your higher source in God. And there are, what do you say, like invisible, you know, if you don't see them, that's an invisible energy that's there to support you, to help you through your health dilemma, your relationship breakup, help you through that financial crisis. You know, help you feel supported when you feel all alone. So every time you see something happen to you, it can often, my friends, be that there's something you're working on in your life and you've been asking for clarity, or you're asking for like a confirmation, a sign. So I'll walk in, I'll be working. Generally, it's like when I notice it is when I'm working on something that's really important to my growth, or a challenge that I'm troubled with, or how to deal with somebody that's popped up, or I'm over feelings of overwhelm and what to do next. And this, all of a sudden I'll be like, oh my God. So I walk in, just even today, I was thinking about, okay, I'm gonna do a video. I'm overdue doing a video, you know, and I went, Colleen, just do it, right? Like Mel Robbins would say, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, right? But I was thinking about, you know, my support team, and there I noticed the vase was moved even more again. So it's like it keeps moving. Okay. Now another sign, way a loved one, you can talk with them or they'll talk back to you, is again, remember, just talk with them. My beloved Rob, he loves to play with electricity. Okay. So if you see common lights turning on and off, could be the street lamps, it could be lights flickering in your home, okay? A lot of you may have heard, you know, you've experienced that. Well, I want you to open up your thought consciousness and look for and listen for things like the radio station where a song comes on that is like with my cousin, Bare Naked Ladies, okay? Bare Naked Ladies is, or Seal, which was a beautiful song, a prayer for the dying, that we played at his funeral. It came in, but the Bare Naked Ladies, it just kind of dates me, if you guys know about them, but they, and he and I, we saw them, we would like listen to them, we would sing them, if you had $1 million, and we had an amazing connection around that, and he was a huge fan of singing. So he was highly electrical, you know, active. This is how you identify if your personality signs. So when you're noticing that there's something happening, relate it back to them. So he was highly electric. He was very active, but he actually bounced. Like he literally like bounced around. You know, he's amazing. He transitioned at 27 biologically, but he would bounce around, and he, shows through radio signs as well. So for him, one of my favorite ones, so you can look for these kind of signs and know when to even, you know, call them in and then go deeper with them when they show up. Go deeper with them. Ask them for help. Ask them to show you. Ask them to bring things on. Ask them to, you know, see what I mean? Just ask, right? So just like a prayer, just like talking to God, ask for your beloved. Allow them to support you. So my favorite thing to remind you guys of is radio stations. Okay, remember I said that? About songs playing? Well, get this, you guys. What if you woke up every morning to radio o'clock and it woke you up to the alarm, and the alarm was really high one morning? Now, you're alone. You haven't shared your house with someone for 4 days. You know what I mean? And you wake up and this radio station volume is high. Well, this is beginning days. I turned it down, didn't really think anything of it. Next day, up high again, turned it down, went for 3 days like that. And I started to feel this vibration, this thinking, this download. So he came into my mind, how it works, comes into your consciousness. It's like, thinking about Rob. Oh, interesting. And then I felt this, I wonder if it's Rob. And then the next fourth morning, I think it was the fourth morning, fourth or fifth, I would say fourth, I wake up and the radio station's on a completely, completely different channel. Okay. And Chinese or Mandarin, not sure. No. And I start cracking up laughing. And you see, Rob was a card, right? He was playing tricks all the time. Kind of like, I don't say tricks, but like humor. So those are a couple ways that you can check out your own beloved. Now, how I've helped my clients, which I can help you, so remember, subscribe, reach out to me. I have a website down below that if you're interested in spiritual communication, two things, look at the spiritual education playlist down below where you get a collection of a few videos. Quite a lot of videos have been building around this subject matter. And watch those, see if you resonate with them, learn from what my experience is, but then filter for yourself, okay? And the other way is to check out my website below. There at ColleenWinia.com, I have a page on spirit communication. So if you want to dive deeper, do that. Reach out to me through that, and we will do a booked private consultation specific to you, so you can get my intuitive guidance, my intuitive readings, and or any education on how to talk to loved ones and become more of a believer, because you probably are already getting these signs or you wouldn't have been watching and listening to the video this long, okay? And lastly, I want to give you an example of one of my clients that had the most cool. I get on my blog, I have a blog on my website that's always, every week, there's new comments being added from people all around the world that are experiencing signs of loved ones or moving objects or electricity or things that they can't explain, you know, a little bit of that paranormal. And it kind of finds its way to this blog. So one of my clients, bless her, I just actually met her, I would say six months ago. Yeah. And she showed up and she was just feeling not good in her body. And that's what I do. I help people feel better through breath work, through body work, through energy work, through educating on spirit communication. So I'm not just. And so she comes in and she had a lot of heaviness on her heart because her mama died. Now it was 2 years ago, but she really feels warmed. She really feels connected. She really feels her mother's presence, and she knows and has become a believer now that her loved one has transitioned, and one of yours is going to transition too. They all do. I've lost about over a dozen people, five, six of them really close to me as I was by their bedside, and my sweetheart just March 7th. So I've got a lot of experience, you guys, with supporting people through transition and the afterlife. Finding that, like recognizing them, talking to them. And so my friend, my client, she's my friend, my client, she actually sees these most amazing rays of light. So she'll be driving in the car. She'll take a picture. Just kind of, I'll tell you what she gets in a minute, but driving in the car and she'll see these rays and sitting at the beach, or all these different facets of signs where she'll see these two streams of parallel, they kind of come like this. And she literally has shown me a picture where she took a picture of this, the windshield. And sure enough, you saw these streams of parallel lights. And then she took a picture while she's sitting at the beach and was watching the sun, I think it was sunset or sunrise, can't remember that. But it was like this. And everything just warmed her heart. It opened up her channel of communication. She became a believer. And it's just fascinating because the veil is opening. More and more people are going to be and are looking for this kind of information. We're all sorting it out. I'm just learning here as I go as well. So absolutely, thank you for joining in. I have one way that can really help you be connected to me, learn from me. If you're not ready for consultation directly, but learn from me through going to my website below or the link called 8 Best Steps to Raise Your Vibration. It's my free ebook, my free e-guide. It's really a short read. And there's 8 best steps to raise your vibration so that you are elevating yourself, so that you can receive the messages for yourself and trust yourself to talk to your beloveds and recognize them all around you. So much love to you. It's absolutely a joy to be in your world. I'm Colleen Winia, Reset Your Vibe Coach, and I help you connect and navigate life transitions of loss and massive change. So if you're dealing with health issues, you're looking for natural plant-based solutions, you're looking to, you know, deal with that relationship challenge you've been through, you are looking for intuitive wisdom for how to make the next steps to make money in your business, reach out for psychic intuitive support, and specifically, for sure, education on loved ones on the other side. Thank you all.